everybody. Feel free to gather around, that would be a lot of fun. I've got something I'd like to share with you today. As I came into the town up there, I noticed that you've got a lot of churches around this place. Can you tell me, is that because you're very religious here? I can see a few smiles, so I think perhaps maybe years ago, maybe in the days of Evan Roberts and the Welsh Revival, maybe came up this far north, maybe then, but perhaps not now. Well, let me ask you, if I can, just another question. Can you tell me, if you raise your hand, who will be going to heaven when they die? Well, don't be shy, everybody, someone tell me, just raise your hand if you're going to go to heaven when you die. Not many hands are raised. In fact, according to the Bible, you may have got that really right. But the Bible teaches that not many will go to heaven. So how do we know who's going to go to heaven? How many people say that? It's the good people, isn't it, who go to heaven? If you live a good life, you've done good things, surely they're the people who go to heaven, aren't they? It's not that why people try to do good deeds for one another. Why they try to give money to charity and that kind of thing. Isn't that a good person? Wouldn't God look at someone's life like that and say, this is a good person, this person can come into heaven? And yet the Bible says that there are none who do good. No, not one. And Jesus said, only God is good. Should that be right? Has God missed something? Did he miss it when you helped that old lady across the road? Did he miss it when you gave your money to charity? Did he not see that? Did he not see it when you helped your neighbour? How can God miss that? Is he blind? I don't think so. The point is, why did you do those things? Why did you give your money to charity and do those good deeds? Is it because you want people to see you as someone who's good? Is it for your status? Is it simply because that's what you wanted to do? How many did it with a thought to God at all? How many did it with a thought to God's honour and God's glory? God who made the sky and the sea and the earth, who gave us this air to breathe, who gives you life, who gives you life. How many did it to give glory and honour to him? The thing is, it's not through good deeds that we're saved. It's not through being a good person, although we are saved to do good deeds. We are only put right with God through his Son, Jesus Christ. Through Jesus Christ who came to earth and died on a cross. Doesn't that sound old-fashioned? Doesn't that sound like a message that belongs in the past? But I've got news for you. It's a message that belongs right here, right now, today, in this modern age. Jesus Christ dying on the cross is as relevant to you and me as it was to those people in the Welsh Revival, was it 100 or so years ago? It's as relevant today and it will be as relevant for as long as this earth is to you. Because there is only one way to go to heaven. There is only one way to be put right with God. And that is through giving your life to Jesus Christ. Not through going to church, not through doing good things, not there's anything wrong with that in itself, but have you given your life to Jesus? Have you turned away from your sin? Have you given your life to God? Have you done that? Have you thought about that? It's no good unless you do it. You know, the Bible says that many hear the word, they hear good things, but he not the hearers of the word, who can expect to receive anything from God. It's those who do what it says. And Jesus said, repent of your sins. Repent and believe. So two things. To repent means to turn away from your sins. To turn away from the selfishness that is in our own hearts, every one of us. And to give our life to God through Jesus Christ. He's the only Savior, the only one who can set you free from the power of sin, set you free from the guilt of sin. But when will you do that? When will you think about these things seriously? It's for now, it's for our day, for this generation to consider that there is only one way to heaven, and that's through Jesus Christ. There is only one way to be saved from the punishment of hell, and that is through Jesus Christ. There is only one way to find peace of mind and peace in your heart. Can you imagine a more valuable gift than that? Peace in your own heart. Peace of mind. So whatever circumstance you're in, you can have peace in your own heart and mind. Now I'm telling you this. The Bible says you this. God sent His Son because He loved you. Heaven, He loved you. Came to die for you. What is your answer today? When I talk about these things, what do you think about it? Can you look at your own life and say, well, there must be more to life than this? Can you look at the sky, the clouds, the birds, the sea, all these things that we love so much that give some joy to us and say to ourselves, God, it's all by chance? I don't think so. I look at my own self and look at our human body, see how we're made by chance. I don't think so. I believe there are three things that remain. Three things that will always be true. They always were true. They're true now. And it always will be true. And these are the three things, okay? First thing, there is a God. Second thing, He has revealed Himself to us through the pages of the Bible. And three, the first thing, God means what He says. And it's up to you whether you take Him seriously or not. It's your choice. We live in a free country. It's your choice. It's a free country. You have to listen to that. But please make a choice. Please make a choice that is based on the right information. That is based on truth. Everyone who repents of their sin, gives their life to God. Everyone who hopes and trusts in Him will be saved. Everyone who rejects Jesus Christ as Lord, everybody who turns their back on Him and says, no, I don't want that, will perish. That's what the Bible says. In essence, that's what the Bible is saying. Then you say, well, maybe I'll think about these things then when I'm a bit older, when I know I'm going to die. Well, can you tell me then the exact day and time when you're going to die? Can you tell me when that's going to be? We don't know, do we? Nobody knows. Only fools would put a day or a time on it because we know what's going to happen to you. How many times you pick up a newspaper and read about this young person who died, who perished in a fire, or was swept out of the sea and drowned, or this young person who was killed by mindless thugs? It's in the paper every day. Young people and older people as well who were not expecting to die.